So you've just opened Affinity Designer and you're either presented with this screen or a new document setup window. If you're like me and you don't see it, simply head on up to File and New. Here's the new document window. If you want to see this every time you open Affinity Designer, simply click on this little checkbox down here, Show on Startup. Before we set up our new document, I just want to run through everything here so you know and understand what it is. So account is the first one. It'll say who the app is licensed to just under there. And on the right hand side, it says my add-ons. Now add-ons are things like brush packs that you might have bought from the Affinity store. You can install and uninstall them from here as it's all from the cloud. If you want to browse the store, just click on the blue button and it will go through to the Affinity store. Moving over to the next section, which is called new, click on that. In this section, you'll be creating your new document, whether it be for web or print. And by the way, if you already know all of this, you can skip to the next section. But basically on the left-hand side, you can scroll down here and think of all of these as presets. Maybe this would be better for print. The end product will be being printed on a piece of paper or something. And then you've got photo or web. So we can go ahead and choose them from here as well. So I just click web there. And I'll choose FHD 1080p. On the right hand side, these are all the settings for that preset. And remember, you don't need to keep these sizes. If you've got your own size in mind, you just type it out there and it's done. So you've got page width, page height, and you see it says PX, that means pixels. So you'll be working in pixels if you create this document. If you don't want pixels, go over to document units, click on that. Maybe you're working in inches, feet, yards, up to you. Then you've got the dots per inch, starts off at 72 there, and you can drag it all the way up, depending if you're going to print, maybe you go a little bit higher to 300. Okay, then you've got create artboard. I want to go into this a little bit more later on, but you can click that and it will create your document with an artboard in place already. Then you've got actual size zoom. I usually leave this on default, but here are some of the options. And then you've got this image placement option, and you've got two options within it, prefer linked or prefer embedded. If you're just starting out, just keep it as prefer embedded. Now, I don't want to go too much into this, but basically it's you telling Affinity how to deal with images, like let's say a photo that you place inside of your Affinity document. If you go for embedded, the photo will be inside of the Affinity file. So the file size will be slightly bigger, but it would be easier just to send to somebody the Affinity file and the photo will be inside of it. If you go for prefer linked, Affinity Designer basically creates a link between the photo, wherever it is on your computer, and the Affinity file. The file size will be a lot smaller, but you just need to be mindful of how you handle and store your files. Make sure they're all in one place, basically, because if you delete or move one of those files from that folder, it will no longer be linked and you'll be prompted to go and find wherever that is. If you want to know more about this or anything Affinity Designer related, simply head on up to the help section, click on Affinity Designer to help, and then just go over to search and we'll just type in embed, press return. And you see here right at the top, embedding versus linking. Go ahead and read that and see what's right for you. But as we're starting out, just keep it as embedded. Okay, moving on to the color tab. This is where you'll choose which color format you'll use. So RGB for more like screens and CMYK for print. You decide which one you want. And also you can use color profile, sRGB, or all of these options here. And you can also start your document off with a transparent background. Remember, you can change all of this later on as well, so it doesn't matter if you make a mistake here. Going over to margins, I don't want to include margins on this one because I'm not going to be creating anything like a magazine or anything like that. Then we've got bleed, you can add that, and scale as well, more for like architecture or people working at certain sizes. So if you're happy with the preset as it is, you can go ahead and press on create.